Hey guys, it's Janice. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be about a four-step note-taking system for law school. And honestly, I've only been studying law for like 4 months, so this won't be the best note-taking system in the world. But I've been using it for the last term and it has gotten me pretty okay grades for the first term, so I think I'm gonna be sticking with it in second term. So before we get into it, I'll just tell you guys what the four steps are. So the first step is lecture notes, which I usually take by hand, but obviously you can also type these out depending on your preference, and I'll get into that a little bit later. The second step is my main body of notes, and I'll usually type these out, and this usually includes my lecture notes plus textbook notes plus any notes I take from articles or extra reading material, and I'll compile all of these into one single document. So these are just my main notes. The third step is where I do something very visual, so I'll usually do like a chart or like mind maps or graphs, basically to help me understand all the concepts. And the last part of this note-taking system is just tutorial notes, and these are usually either typed or handwritten. Okay, so lecture notes. I mentioned that I handwrite my notes, but actually I mostly just do that for property and contract law because those subjects are a little bit more difficult and I need to use like arrows and little charts to make myself understand the topic even during the lecture. But what I do is during the lecture, I'll write all of my notes with one pen because there really isn't enough time for you to switch around and use different colors during the lecture, so just stick with one pen and scribble. But the most important part of lecture notes is you actually have to ultimately understand what you wrote during the lecture. And what I do is after every single lecture, I'll go home and immediately look through my notes one more time and I highlight them. So what I do with my colors is I just have a color for cases, a color for statutes, a color for headings, and so on. And I'll just read through my notes one time highlighting. And the main point of this part is simply just to go through all the content one more time just to make sure I understood everything. And by highlighting, I can really remember all the important cases and all the important statutes and just get all the most important information into my head right after the lecture. And also sometimes in the lecture when your handwriting is so bad that it's barely legible, this is the perfect time for you to fix any of those bits because this is when you actually still remember what the lecturer said, so that a couple weeks later, you won't suddenly look at your untouched notes and think, oh my god, what was I writing? And so it's very important to do this right after your lecture. For those of you who prefer typing out your notes, you can basically go through the same process, which is look through all of your notes and fix any typos. And the main thing to know here is that it's not really the final notes that matter, it's actually the process of looking through your lecture notes, because your lecture notes are never going to be completely comprehensive. So what you want to get most from this stage of your studying is just understand what you know and what you don't know, and get the gist of things, because that's how you can move on to your next stage of studying. The second stage of studying is basically to make a set of complete notes. And you need to put loads of things in there, so maybe like your textbook notes and article notes, and also include some vital information from what you took back in your lecture notes. And so the way I go about this is, first of all, I'll do textbook notes because the textbook really has most of the information you need. So I'll just take the textbook and I'll highlight slash underline slash circle out the important information. And as I read, I'll be typing out notes. So this process usually takes a couple hours, but it's very important to really read your textbook carefully because you really can't miss any information from the textbook. Once you finish your textbook notes, you'll be at my least favorite stage of studying, which is reading articles or further reading. I really, really don't like this part. It's so boring to me, but you still have to do it because this is how you get a first. And so basically what you want to do is read through all of your articles, highlight them when appropriate, and just type out your notes on the articles. The most important thing you want to get from your articles is really just what the academic thinks about the topic or whether he agrees or disagrees with something. So your article notes don't have to be as comprehensive or as long-winded as your textbook notes, but rather just remember in a few sentences what the academic's opinion is so that you can cite him in your essays. And after I finish reading my articles, I'll also compile them into my textbook notes from earlier and put them in the right places, so that now I have a full document of every single thing I will need to study for my classes. And finally, you can't forget your cases. So what I do when I take notes of my cases is I just compile them with the rest of my notes, and I put them in little boxes so that I have the case name, the facts, and the main ruling side by side so that I have all the information I need. And yeah, that's basically my main body of notes. These notes pretty much contain every single thing I'll ever need to know for that topic. And so once I'm satisfied with my notes, I'll print them out and highlight them. Once you're done with your full sets of notes, you can now move on to the third stage, which is kind of my favorite stage. And this is when you try to absorb everything you've ever learned and try to put it onto one piece of paper in a very visual format. So I guess this only helps if you're a very visual thinking person, but for me personally, I love making mind maps or flowcharts, especially for property law, because I feel like that topic is just very complicated and I always need graphs to help me understand what I'm learning. And so you can just make these kind of graphs to consolidate your memory and to make sure you can really understand how everything links together. Finally, it's your tutorial notes. And you can't really have a formula for how to write tutorial notes because it really does depend on your tutor. But what I do for some tutors is I will type out my notes because they ramble on a lot during the tutorial, so I need to type out everything they say really quickly. Or sometimes when your tutor likes to use a whiteboard and draw out stuff, maybe you'd like to take a piece of paper and do that too. So sometimes for my tutorials, I'll just draw what the tutor draws out on the board and I will have hammered the tutorial notes. So this part is the last part of your studying, because after your tutorial, you're basically done with that topic until the exams. So yeah, yay, you're finished. And so that basically completes my video as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you're also studying law, I hope this was mildly helpful. And please let me know in the comments what videos you guys would like to see next. I could do more law school videos, but if a very small percentage of you actually study law, then I could make other kinds of videos too. And yeah, so I have an Instagram, which is on all my study stuff and bullet journal stuff, which is at everythingjanice, so you could click the link in the description to go to that. And I also have a personal Instagram which you could follow, and the link is also down below. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye!